A reading from the Holy Gospel according to John. After this, Jesus went to the other side of the Sea of Galilee, also called the Sea of Tiberias. A large crowd kept following him because they saw the signs that he was doing for the sick. Jesus went up the mountain and sat down there with his disciples. Now the Passover, the festival of Jews, was near. When he looked up and saw a large crowd coming toward him, Jesus said to Philip, "Where are we to buy bread for these people to eat?" He said this to test him, for he himself knew what he was going to do. Philip answered him, "6 months' wages would not buy enough bread for each of them to give a little." One of his disciples, Andrew, Simon Peter's brother, said to him, "There is a boy here who has 5 barley loaves and 2 fish. But what are they among so many people?" Jesus said, "Make the people sit down." Now there was a great deal of grass in the place, so they sat down, about 5,000 in all. Then Jesus took the loaves, and when he had given thanks, he distributed them to those who were seated. And so also the fish, as much as they wanted. When they were satisfied, he told his disciples, "Gather up the fragments left over, so there's nothing may be lost." So they gathered them up, and from the fragments of the 5 barley loaves left by those who had eaten, they'd filled 12 baskets. When the people saw the sign that he had done, they began to say, "This indeed is the prophet who has come into the world." When Jesus realized that they were about to come to take him by force to make him king, he withdrew again to the mountain by himself. The Gospel of the Lord. In this gospel today, the reading talks about abundance. It talks about, obviously, this amazing miracle, which actually features in all 4 gospels. And what is, I think, actually the only miracle that features in all 4, which shows its importance and the idea of abundance and limitless. And this is what God's love for us is like. It comes in abundance and it is completely limitless. And I think sometimes we struggle to think in that sort of way because our lives aren't limitless. In fact, we live by limits. We are limited on how much we can understand, when we are supposed to go to bed, when we get up, how much we're supposed to eat, how much screen time we're allowed to have, how much mobile data we have. Even if we went somewhere and it said all you can eat buffet, we'd still be limited by how much our body could take, and we would have to stop at some point. So the idea of something being limitless, like Jesus's love, is so awesome. It's so powerful and amazing, and something that we really do need to understand, and at least appreciate. So if we're going to appreciate it, I think that today perhaps we should take some time to write a prayer of gratitude, a thank you prayer, a thank you prayer to God to say, "Thank you for your love. Thank you for your unending love for us that knows no limits and comes, just like the miracle today, in absolute abundance."